previous one we did actually have that worked.
I am a
one of the things about being an elder now is that I have come to rely on young people for leadership as happened when I was coming up. And watching it pass is a beautiful thing. To people of African descent here that were born in this country, never forget that we are the children of survivors of the Little Palace. We are children of survivors of Jim Crow. We are children of survivors of those who survived emancipation. We are survivors of those who have lived another 28 hours. Some of us on new ground has been about bringing together people and including sexual orientation, transgender, gay, lesbian, bisexual people at the center of it, because we have been a part of the organizing. We have been a part of our collective communities all along. And it brings us full circle. The sun circles the earth. The moon circles. Did I say that right? The sun circles the earth. Thank you, baby. Thank you. The sun. The earth circles the sun. The moon circles the earth. We have water that falls down into oceans and it's taken back up again. And then falls down again, creating the circle that gives us the water that we drink, that we need to survive. And completing the circle, seeing our different oppressions and the way in which they're linked is critically important. I have been discriminated against based on my race, based on my gender, based on my economic status, and based on the fact that I love women dearly. And I have been with a woman for 30 years now. She's the love of my life. And these oppressions hold up each other. There has always been an attempt, it's the same formula. First to dehumanize, you are not like us. Then to demonize, you are definitely not human. And then to destroy, because it's okay to kill a demon. And I heard those words today. There's something, every time I heard about what was happening today, I kept thinking about a white man just a short time ago who was firing a gun and shooting at people, and the police wounded him in the leg. I keep waiting to hear reports about wounded youth, not dead youth, that there's something wrong. And it's the same policing that has existed for a long, long time. We want a system where our legal system will yield justice. And there is no justice without us.
Come on now.
We have a right to be. And someone told me on a campaign one time that everybody knows somebody got an uncle named Peaches. What the larger community doesn't understand, that in rallying around Michael Brown, that all the communities that are rallying and protesting and pissed about what's happened, which is the status quo, is that it's happening in all of our communities. It's not isolated. It's not new. We have had enough. And it's time that we stand together. There's no justice without us. When the oppressor is telling you that the oppression is over, there's something wrong. The oppressed should be the one saying, everything is fine now. And people that tend to speak to that tend to be people who belong to the majority. But take heart. All we've had all along is for our people who stepped out on nothing and landed on something. We come from resilience. We come from strength. We come from people who know how to laugh and love and work and resist. We will not bow down to what is happening now. We will stand strong. The intimidation, there was a lot of talk about how many police forces would be gathered, yet we were not the ones talking about violence. And when there is trouble, most of the time it's a police riot. people who have been licensed to carry guns and supposed to serve and protect our communities are serving and protecting themselves and business interests. Stand strong. Know that we are united around our common humanity and that we will not fragment based on black and brown and white. That we will stand together for justice because we are united as human beings in a struggle for our very survival. And we will not surrender, we will not give up, we will stand together.
All right.
Thank you. Thank you.